Hi, and welcome to this ForNAV Coffee Break. My name is René Brümmel. I'm a product specialist at ForNAV, and I will be your presenter today. With me today is Jacob Rasmussen to answer any question you may have about the ForNAV Direct Print and File Service. As this coffee break is live, you can ask your questions via the GoToWebinar question window. We will answer them at the end of the coffee break. This is the third and final coffee break in our Direct Print series. In this coffee break, we're going to set up direct printing of your Business Central reports using the ForNAV Service Print. For Business Central on-premise and cloud, you can use Service Print. In Business Central, you can set up a direct printer to use Service Print. When Service Print is selected, the print job is placed in a print queue in Business Central. This means that the print job is stored in a table in the Business Central database. It is not sent to an external service. When a print job is ready in the print queue, it is picked up by a Windows service running on a PC or server on your network. The service communicates with the print queue in Business Central using OData API via HTTPS. In addition to the communication between the print queue in Business Central and the local Windows service, there is an online signaling mechanism. When Business Central has a job ready in the print queue, it signals the local service. There is no job information in the signaling. An outgoing HTTPS call is made from the Business Central to send the signal, and an outgoing HTTPS call is made from the Windows service to pick up the signal. The purpose of the signaling is to improve performance and reduce the load on Business Central. It is not vital to the operation of Direct Print. Printing will work without signaling if necessary. The Direct Print service runs locally on your network and can connect to your printers and print the jobs from the queue. It runs as a Windows user, which must have permission to access the printers. To demonstrate how to print Business Central reports directly, I'm going to use these steps. The prerequisites, what do I need to get going? In step two, I will install the Direct Print Windows service on my print server. In step three, I will set up the Direct Print service. In step four, I will set up the printers. Let's start with the first step. Today, I will be printing reports in the Business Central Cloud Tenant with the Business Central 2023 Wave 2 release. I've installed the ForNAV customizable report pack, and I've executed the step-by-step wizard from the assisted setup to get started. ForNAV Direct Print is available in Business Central on-premise and cloud from version 16 and up. You need at least ForNAV version 6.2. We advise you to always use the latest version of ForNAV since we regularly add new features. The first thing we need to do is install the ForNAV Direct Print service on our print server. We can download the Direct Print client from the ForNAV website. So let's go to our print server, and this is just an Azure server that we use for development. And the first thing we do is to download ForNAV from fornav.com/download, and you just install the regular installer that you also use for the ForNAV designer. If you've downloaded that, which I did before because it takes a while to download, you can run it. And if you run this installer, you can select which components you want to install. And if you just want to use the Direct Print and File Service, you need to select Direct Print and File Service. This does not have to run on a Business Central server, so the server that you're installing this on doesn't need to have the Business Central service tier installed to it. I will hit cancel because I did all of this before. It takes too long to do this during a webinar. Then the next step after installing the ForNAV Direct Print service is to open the services and find the ForNAV Direct Print service and to set the user that is going to be used to run this service. In this case, I've chosen the user manager because that's a user that has access to this server and has access to all of the printers. And what you need to do in this case is just to select a user that has access to the printers on this server. Once you've done that, you can start or restart the print service. So that's the print service. And then finally, whilst we are on this server, we're going to have a look at printers we have on this server. And in this case, I have a bunch of standard printers, the Microsoft Printer PDF and the XPS document writers. And I've installed a generic text only printer. This is a demo printer. It doesn't actually print anything. It's a virtual printer. And you can see that it is paused. And if I open the print queue, there's nothing in there. So anything that I'm going to print on this is going to get stuck in the print queue, which is great for demo purposes because I don't actually want to waste any paper printing my demo files. Now, what you often need to do when you connect printers to Business Central, especially when you start printing to label printers, is to select the printing preferences. Now, normally what you would do on your own machine is to go to the printing preferences for the printer. The problem is when I set this up, I'm going to set up the printing preferences for the user that is currently logged in. I don't want to do that because the user that is currently logged in is not the user that is going to be printing from the ForNAV file service. As you remember, we set the ForNAV file service, the ForNAV Direct Print and file service to use the manager account. So that's not going to use these printing preferences. To set the printing preferences, you need to go to printer properties, then advanced, and then set your printing defaults. And that's going to change the preferences for all of the users on this specific machine. Once all of that is set up, your printer is set up, ForNAV is set up, and we can move on to the second step. And the second step is to set up the direct printing. The second step to set up direct printing is to configure ForNAV direct printing in Business Central. Typically, we need to tell ForNAV where our Business Central server is and how to communicate with it. This setup is slightly different for cloud and on-premise. I will demonstrate the setup for cloud today. For on-premise, you also need to set the authentication to connect to Business Central. So let's go to Business Central. And you can see that my Business Central is running in a browser on my local PC. So it is not running in the browser of the server that I'm setting up as the print service. I will open the ForNAV Direct Print setup. There we go. And if I open that for the first time after installing ForNAV, I get the question, do you want to set up ForNAV Direct Print using a wizard? Yes, of course I do, because that makes my life easier. And the first thing I get is the ForNAV print config file that I'm going to need to set the settings on my print server. I'm going to get back to that later. It contains security keys, so make sure you delete it when you're done with it. So that's the first thing. The second thing it says is that the local print service communicates with Business Central. And for it to be able to do this, you must register a ForNAV external application and grant consent. Do you want to do that now? Yes, I do. And what ForNAV does now, it creates a Microsoft Entra application. And in all the versions of Business Central, that's called the Microsoft Azure Active Directory application card. It sets all of this up perfectly for ForNAV, and all you need to do is grant consent. This needs to be done by a user who has the permissions to grant consent in Azure. So not everybody can do this. Make sure that an administrator does this. And once you do this, you need to set the permission. I say accept. And that's all we need to do in Business Central. So now what we can do is open the ForNAV Direct Print setup. Then you will see that this stuff is set up. I've downloaded the service keys, and now all I need to do is open my server. There we go, and I will paste my configuration, my direct print configuration to the server, and if I double click it, that will open the config in the ForNAV direct print, and it will set up a connection to my Business Central tenant. And you can see that it is connected now and it is waiting. And if you are on premise, like I said before, you need to set your authentication to whatever authentication you need for Business Central. For now, this is set up, and I can move on to the next part of the coffee break. So finally, we need to set up our printers in Business Central. Business Central needs to know which printers exist and how to communicate with them and which reports to use for which printers. So the first thing I do is from the ForNAV Direct Print and File setup, I go to my Direct Printers. And in my Direct Printers, you can see the default printer, which is a ForNAV Direct Print client printer because it doesn't use the queue jobs. And I will simply add a new printer in here. And since I'm using Service Print, I can choose from my local printers. And you can see that I've got the same three printers that I had installed on my printer server. And I will choose the generic text only printer. And it says you have selected a printer connected to Direct Print, which means that the queue jobs is now set to true. And we'll give it a name and a description. And that's my printer setup. Now I can set up things like paper kind, landscape, duplex, color, and all sorts of stuff as well. For this coffee break, all I need to do is set up my standard printer. So that's step two. The next step is to choose which report is going to be printed on this printer. To do that, I'm going to open the, not the direct printers, but the printer selection. And in the printer selection, I can create a new line. I will select the invoice. From the invoice, I'm going to choose the ForNAV invoice. And like we said before, you can use any RDLC or Word report for ForNAV direct printing. It all works. And I'm going to select the generic printer that I just created. Now, I'm not setting this up for a specific user ID, but if you want, you can set these printers up for specific users on specific printers. So that's that. Now, if I go to my ForNAV standard reports, you'll find that the ForNAV standard invoice report is now connected to the generic printer. And if I local printers, Business Central is going to print all of my invoices, all of the posted invoices in my demo database to my local printer. Since I'm not wasting paper, I don't really mind if it is going to print 200 pages. And Business Central has sent the print job, which means that on my print server, I can find my printer. And if I open the queue, you will see that the ForNAV VAT sales invoice has been added to the print queue. If this was a real printer and the printer wasn't paused, this would now be spitting out loads of paper. So that's how you would print. Then, of course, ForNAV has a bunch of logging and error checking in it as well. So if I go back to the ForNAV direct print, if I go back to the setup, I can find my print queue. And in the print queue, ForNAV logs whatever has been printed. You can see that this is the ForNAV VAT sales invoice that I've just printed. The status is finished. I can restart it, which means it's going to be printed again, or I can download the print job, or I can delete it. Now, of course, you don't want to store all of your finished print jobs in the print queue. That's going to take up a lot of space and might not be very secure to keep everything in there. So what you can do is select the delete finished print jobs. And if you select that, then print jobs are going to be deleted whenever they're finished. This is recommended for production systems. If you're just testing, just leave this switched off so you can see what has happened. Finally, on our print server, we have some more detailed logging as well. When you install ForNAV Direct Print, it will install a folder in the program data, in this case, program data / ForNAV / direct print. And in there, you have some configuration where you can change the configuration. In most cases, the default configuration will be fine. If it isn't, you can find some details on the in the ForNAV knowledge base on how to set up the configuration and how to change it. And you can find logs. And in the logging, if I open this, you can see everything that has happened. So you can see right here that I've been getting printer settings. And I think if I scroll further down, you will see that the ForNAV VAT sales invoice has been printed to the generic text only printer. And that will give you some tools on how to monitor and configure your ForNAV direct printing. So let's recap what we just did. The first thing we did was to install the direct print service on our print server. Once we had installed that, we were able to configure the direct print service in Business Central. Finally, we have set up the direct printers and the printer selection. When we printed, the print job was sent directly to my printer service. You can find more information on ForNAV Direct Print Service and how to set it up in a knowledge base article linked on screen right here. This concludes our three-part coffee break series on direct printing. I can see we have no questions at the moment, so I'm going to continue and wrap up this coffee break. If you want to know more about ForNAV, or if you want to download the ForNAV Designer and Converter, please visit our website. If you want to install ForNAV in Business Central Cloud, please visit the Microsoft App Source. You can watch more videos about ForNAV on our YouTube channel. And if you have any questions about ForNAV, please email them to support@fornav.com. For a full list of upcoming and recorded coffee breaks, please visit fornav.com/coffee break. Thank you very much for joining me today, and goodbye.